Guys, it's Carrie with Viewership, and today I'm bringing you another step-by-step YouTube walkthrough, and we are going to talk end cards today. And if you're not familiar with end cards, let me show you right here on this video. End cards show up in the last 20 seconds of your video, and they're a way for you to point your viewers to other videos, other playlists, a subscribe button. It's a really great tool that's within YouTube, so it's super simple and you've really got no excuses. So you got to be using end cards, and it doesn't have to look fancy like this. I'll show you a super simple way to add these if you're just getting started with YouTube. So we're on our channel here. We want to go into the YouTube studio, so click on this button right here, and that will take us into our channel dashboard. From here, we're going to click on the video icon, and that will take us to all of the videos we've uploaded to YouTube. We're gonna go ahead and work on this batching video. And what we wanna do to get inside of the video and to make additions like end cards and info cards, we'll click on it. And you'll see you're on the video details page. This is where you put in your title, your description, your tags, your thumbnail. Last week we walked through info cards. And today we're gonna check out end screens. So there are a couple ways to add end screens. One is through the editor over here. That's a little more advanced and it can be a little intimidating. So today we're just gonna keep it simple. We'll click on end screens over here, again, right below info cards. So let's go ahead and click on that, see where it takes us. Okay, so here we are. And this timeline down here is showing us the last 20 seconds of our video. And that is where you can put these cards on your video to help your viewers, like I said, in the last 20 seconds, discover different videos. You can put a subscribe button, you can link to another channel, and you can link to an approved website. So for our purposes today, we're gonna keep it simple. We're gonna add a video or a playlist and a subscribe button. Again, YouTube makes this really, really simple. So let's go ahead and click Add Element. And let's say, so hold on, let me go back there and explain what we're looking at. So if you want to add a video or a playlist, it's going to show up over here in a little rectangle, and it's clickable. So your viewers will be able to click right on that at the end of your video and go straight to your video or your playlist. So let's click Create. And you have some options here. You can send them to your most recent upload. You can choose to have YouTube decide which video would be best for your viewer. Or you can pick a very specific video. Let's say you mentioned another video within this video and you want to make sure people have access to it easily. You can opt to add that in. Or you can point them to a playlist. The great thing about pointing viewers to a playlist is it typically keeps people on your channel longer because the playlist will autoplay, so videos will keep continually playing. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's add a playlist. We're gonna click choose a playlist. And let's, for, you know, we're talking about optimizing videos and we talked about info cards, so let's add the playlist YouTube tutorials. So we'll go ahead and click on this. So you click on the playlist that you want. We want this one. So we clicked on it, it's highlighted, and we'll click Create Element. And voila, there it is. And you can move it around. So let's say, let's go ahead and preview this. There's a little preview slider over here. So I'm gonna click on Preview, and it'll show you, it fades in. And this is where it's going to land when you moved it around, and your viewers will be able to click on that. So if we click out of Preview, we can go ahead and move this around again. And we wouldn't really want it over here covering up Adam's face, so let's preview it again. And it'll just say that doesn't work. Yeah, we don't want that box covering up his face. So let's go ahead and move it over here. Then we're gonna add another element. Let's go ahead and add a subscribe button. And there it is, YouTube populates it for you. Again, we don't want it over here in the left-hand corner because it's gonna cover his face. So we can put it down here, we can put it in the middle, wherever we want. I'll just put it lower left. And then another cool thing that you can do is you can change the timing of how long these elements stay up on your end screen. So let's say you really want to drive home the fact, you know, you only want this video, you really want people to watch this video. So if we pull it out for the full 20 seconds, you'll see if you're watching this blue playhead down here, your card is up there for the full 20 seconds. And then here is where your subscribe button's going to come in for the last 5 seconds of your video. It's pretty cool and it's really intuitive. Let's go ahead and add a third. I'll show you what best for viewer looks like. So if you click best for viewer, create element, you'll get a card here. We're going to move that away from Adam's face. And let's just, for fun, so you can see how this works, we'll have it show up right around here. So we drag our blue playhead back. I'm going to click on preview and let's see how this looks. So it goes right into the video that we want to highlight. And then right around here, best for viewer card will pop up. Okay, so YouTube has determined that this video is the best for the particular viewer who's watching right now. And then boom, our subscribe button, our clickable subscribe button will pop up right there. So this looks pretty good. I want to go ahead and I'm happy with this, happy with the way it looks. Remember to click save. And voila, you're done. But another cool thing that you can do here is, like, let's say you're in a hurry. I'm going to go ahead and delete all these. Let's delete these. So if you click on the pencil button, you can delete if you want to edit. Boom. Okay. So everything's gone. Let's say you're in a hurry and you just want to use the same thing that you used for your last video. So you click import from video and you know, hey, I want to use the end cards that I used on this last video. Highlight your video, click on it, import, and boom. It will keep the same format and it keeps the same timing as well too. So you got to keep that in mind. If you want it to be longer, you can pull these out. Grab and hold these little gray boxes, drag them out to be a little bit longer. But YouTube makes it really simple. I like to just take the time every time that I come in to optimize a video to be really intentional about the end cards because they're super helpful. And it's a great, great tool to get people to stick around on your channel and to discover more info that you're putting out there that you've made for them. So let's go ahead and add back in our elements. We're going to do video or a playlist. We're going to add a playlist. We'll add our YouTube tutorial playlist, create element. We'll move that away from Adam's face. We're gonna add another element. Let's do our subscribe button. There it is. I'm gonna move that away from Adam's face. So you just click and drag, put it down in the bottom left corner. I'm gonna have that show up a little later in the video. It has to be at least 5 seconds long, so YouTube won't let you make this any shorter. You can try, but they won't let you. And then finally, we're going to add best for viewer. Click on that, create element, best for viewer. And we click and we'll drag that away from Adam's face into the bottom right-hand corner. When we're done and we're happy, actually, I want to make this a little longer. Let's put it here. Let's preview it one more time. Okay, so there's our first video. And then best for viewer is going to come in down here. There it is, best for viewer. And then our subscribe button will come on in the last 5 seconds. And there we go. We'll click save. And then we're going to click upper right, return to YouTube Studio. Let's go back into our videos. And that is how you add end cards to your video. It's a really great way, again, like I said, it's a great way to just make more of your content discoverable for your audience. And if you missed it, last week we walked through what to do with info cards. So I'll go ahead and post that video here. You can watch that if you're curious about how to add end cards. And let me know down in the comments, what has you stumped on YouTube? What are you struggling with? Are you working in the new YouTube studio? Do you have questions? Let me know. I'm happy to answer them, happy to make step-by-step videos. And I will see you in the next video.